trees, you can leave your worries. Listen to the waves. Say you wanna get so high, breathe me in like air tonight. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Tiffany. So today I'm going to do a video of doing how to survive on the first day of college too. So new, but if you're new, say welcome, subscribe and press the bell notification, hashtag notification squad. And so let's get started on this video, because I did a video for the high school survive, how to survive the first day of high school. So go back and watch that first one for the ones that aren't going to high school, and the ones who are in high school already, but that's just kind of want to get advice on things about that. So okay, I know some of y'all might already in your college and already like in your dorms or already got your other stuff, but I still want to kind of still make this video. And is living on campus, if you are living on campus, if you already got your stuff that you need to have, you're going to live in a college, like, you know, a university college, if you are going to do that, just have the stuff that you need to have for that dorm. Like, you know, you could have like your covers you have in your room, or if you're going to buy some covers that you got, just have all that stuff that you have for your room, like making like as like a home thing, like as like your room from home or something like that. I'm trying to have that. Oh, why my eyes just still messed up right now. And with that, if you do live on campus, is that have a roommate that are a good roommate, that's somebody that you want, somebody that is not so, let me turn this little thing up because it's just kind of, that is not so, have a good roommate, I'm trying to say. But if you are like living off campus, the university, or if you're at community college, because I know community colleges, they don't have like, sorry, I'm touching my hair, it's just messed up. I know in community college they don't have like dorms, so it's a little different. But if you are on off campus, just have the stuff that you have, your class, your supplies, your ID, technologies like your phone, iPad, laptop, have all that stuff. Number two, for the first day of class, go and find your classes. I mean, first day of school, college, go find it. Makes it easier if you do like that, if you go and find your classes before the first day, because that's what I did when I was in college, and find my classes, because sometimes it's hard to try to, know when you're on your first day, or if you are transferring from college, still go find it before that day, because it makes it easier to do that thing. Number three, listen to your college teachers too. Ask questions about the class, about what you need to do to kind of pass the class and that kind of thing. And also, sometimes they will probably tell you what supplies you need to have for that class. I will say that of that parking here. I am so sorry, y'all. I'm just trying to kind of make it kind of not too bright in here. For number four, I would say sign up for the test center. It's like a test place that you go take your tests. If you don't want to take your tests in your class, you can sign up for like a test to make the time and date for you to take your test for the class that you, what subject of your class that you're taking, and let your teacher know, because I know some teachers of the college instructors, college, would tell you if you need to like sign up for the, it would call the disability center test. So that's where you go, because if you're not on disability, you still can like go there and take your tests too, because it still will help if you got the problem. If you have if you can't focus on your tests and it's a lot of noise and you can't able to do that, and you like to take your time on your tests, go there, because that's what I did. And I think I was just stressing out a lot, and that's part of why I took a break from college for a while. Right now I am taking a break. We'll see when I'm going back, probably in 3 years. For number five, sign up for a tutor. Have a tutor to kind of help you. I know some tutors won't help you with your homework, because they won't, but they can help you with your tests. I think they will help you with your homework. I don't think they will let you. I don't think so. No, they don't. They will help you study and help you how to figure out yourself on the homework and that kind of thing. I think that's what they do. I think they do help you with your homework. I don't know for sure. It's been so long, I forgot. don't think they do. Number six, sign up for a lunch card. I know in colleges they have like these lunch cards they have that you can sign up for, and that's what I had from at Plastic Tech. I still got the card, and it's a card that you can put money on it to pay for your, you know, pay for your food with your lunch card, student lunch card. And I think that's what they have to have, because I know college is supposed to have them. All college is supposed to have like that, especially community college and university college too. They post that. Number seven, ask like your classmates for on your first day. Ask like one of your classmates to have like if someone's sitting next to you, ask them, do they want to do like be a study group, a study like study buddy, like study like, you know, for a test or something. Ask for their cell number, email, so that y'all can study for a test and stuff, and help each other on the study for tests. And I think, and with the homeworks, I think they would help you too with your homeworks. I don't think so. I forgot, because this has just been so long. I don't think you sign up. You can't make up like a, have a classmate to have like a study group. Y'all could like have that, and it makes it kind of better to do that, so you don't have to study by yourself. You can have them to help you study and help you with that. For number eight, like I said, pick like the right roommate if you're going to live on campus, a university campus. I don't know if they would let you pick the right roommate, but I think they would tell you what type of roommate you want. I think that's what they probably do. I think some campuses do that. I don't know for sure, but I think that's what they do. I never lived on campus before, but my brother did. So the first college he went to, but he transferred. So, but number nine right now. Write down like the supplies you need to have for your classes, and still ask questions to one after the class. After class is over, ask your instructor, of your teacher, of your college teacher, to ask them, can they give you what you need to do to pass class, and what supplies you need to have and stuff like that. And be on time with your classes, especially on first days too. You can't miss out on that. So, number 10, I would say, is that on your first day, just have a notebook, pen, pencil, and have that on your first day. You really, in college, you really don't have to have like all your supplies with you. You could just like have just a notebook and a folder with you, so you can, because they will give you like it's like instructions of your class to pass the class, because they will have like a paper. I wish I had my own papers, but they have like a list of to pass the score classes that you need to have, what grades you need to pass, because they would have all that. And so yeah, have that. That's on your first day. Okay, the last one, number 11, like I said to the high school kids, is it's okay to be nervous on your first day of college. It is okay to be nervous. So that's why I would tell you that it is okay to be nervous. I'm still be nervous when I go to college, especially on the second day. You still be nervous. It's okay to be nervous. It's just, you just will be used to of it, and you will meet new friends, or you might have some seasonal friends that you know. And I will just say that, and welcome to college. And just have fun, and that's what I would say. I would go back to college probably in 2020 or 21. Probably go back and finish my social degree, because I do need to finish. I might explain about a video of that separate from this Monday. Why I left college. I did one before, but I gotta go. Just like, comment, and subscribe, and press the bell notification. Like I said, hashtag notification squad. And I will, some days when I have like comments on my videos, I will pop up of the next person who pops up on my screen, and a shout out to them to subscribe to my channel. And that's what I would do, and I'll see you in my next video. Peace. Hey guys, it's Sydney Soa Beckham. Dang it. Oh lord. Hey guys, today. I say hey guys.